Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Sunday morning and the Old Cookbook Show. Today, we're going to do a recipe out of this little cookbook called The Pennsylvania Dutch and Their Cookery. This was sent in by a viewer, and I love getting cookbooks sent in by viewers. I love that you're entrusting me with these old cookbooks. And it also helps me fill out gaps in my book collection. And mainly because a lot of these cookbooks that I get are not ones that I would normally stumble across, or I might not actually pick up. But once I've got them in my hand, I find them very interesting, like this one. This is probably half history of the German immigration starting in the late 1600s to Pennsylvania, and how they developed their own language and their own cooking, and they lived separate from the rest of America, trying to grasp onto where they came from, but struggling to deal with the new world. And the recipes. And the recipes really do show sort of a crossover of German cooking meshed with English and other immigrant cooking that you would find in the United States in this time period. And so this cookbook is from 1935. And the recipe that we're going to do today is Dutch applesauce cake. Now, a point of confusion that I often see in the comment sections underneath recipes from the Pennsylvania Dutch. People from Holland saying, I'm Dutch and I have no clue what you're talking about. This has nothing to do with Holland. It's an English misread of Deutsch that becomes Dutch. And they talk about that in the beginning of this book and how that language evolved in these closed communities. So the first thing into the mixer is butter. And I'm just gonna beat that to soften it up a little bit first. This mixer's starting to sound like I need to take it apart and fix it. Not a big deal. I've done that in the past. I think I could do it again. Next in is brown sugar and all of the spices. So in goes the brown sugar. Next is cinnamon and cloves. There's no instruction of what to do with the salt, so I'm going to throw that in there as well. And then it calls for one whole grated nutmeg. And I gotta tell you, that is a lot of nutmeg. I don't know that I'm gonna put in a whole grated nutmeg. I might stop at half. Well, maybe more than half. Maybe I'll go as far as I can go before I start to grate my fingers off. That's about it. Okay. So, close this up and cream that all together. Now, this is an applesauce cake, so I have some applesauce here, and I'm supposed to mix the baking soda into the applesauce. So I'll get that mixed in as best I can. And then it says to mix the applesauce and the flour into this mixture. So I'm going to mix them kind of half and half, or third and third and third. A little bit of applesauce, a little bit of flour, let those mix in. And then I'll come back and add a little more applesauce and a little more flour. Now the cake batter came together really nicely in the mixer. Tastes amazing. I licked the beater. I did lick the beater. Tastes amazing. Last ingredient are some raisins. I never flour fruit before I put it in a cake. I don't believe that it makes any difference in fruit distribution. I don't think that fruit sinks to the bottom if you don't coat it in flour first. Maybe that's something we should test out at some point. And I also didn't reconstitute the raisins. And the reason I didn't do that is I know that a lot of people say to soak the raisins first in something or heat them in the microwave with a little bit of water, plump them up again. For some recipes, I think that is important. I really do think that is important for some recipes. But for other recipes, I often feel like that just makes the recipe or the resulting cake a little bit stodgy, a little bit too wet, a little bit too moist. And that the raisins, if you don't soak them, they pick up a little bit of moisture, which gives you a better texture in the cake. And I'm not sure which way this cake is going to go. So I didn't want to do it off the bat. I want to taste the cake first and decide if in a future version of this, if I need to do it. And I think that's, well, I know that's the way I roll. So it is an important step in some recipes to soak your raisins. But in other recipes, I wouldn't do it at all. And I'd be afraid to do it the first time just until I was sure. So I hope that helps you. There are so many cooking rules that people promote as you must do this every time, when the reality is it's a little bit more subtle than that. It's not always black and white. There's a lot of gray area, and you sometimes shouldn't do it. So I've got the oven preheated to 350 degrees because my only baking direction is bake in a moderate oven. Doesn't even tell me the size of pan, so I've chosen a 9x9. I'm going to smooth this out, get it in the oven, and see what happens. Hey, Jules.
Hey, Glen. Hey, friends. What's with your fancy knife trick there?
It's a good-looking piece of cake. Okay, so there you go.
Dates and raisins?
Just raisins.
Oh, just raisins. It's got that smell, though. That sweet, fruity.
Yes. So it is a Dutch applesauce cake. I might just have the rest of your piece.
I shouldn't have taken such a big bite. That was good, though. It's nice and moist.
This is what I, in my brain, I don't know if anybody else, this is what I consider a snack cake. Does that make sense? It's a snackin cake. There's a brand in the 70s called snackin cake.
I don't really remember anything about it, though. The name sounds familiar, but I understand what you mean. It's kind of like, I don't.
It's not a presentation cake. It's not a fancy cake. It's a really good cake.
To have with tea?
But it's that thing that you kind of snack on. Like, you don't present this at a birthday party or at the end of a fancy meal.
Understood. Mm-hmm. Understood. I'm willing to have more, though, just so you know. So
I could see my grandfather at the table dipping this into corn syrup.
Because what you want is some more sugar in it. It's really quite tasty.
And then back out, and he'd be back out on the tractor doing his day's work. Yeah, it's a really good cake. Okay, so Dutch applesauce cake. I really like the spices in it. It's moist. It's delicious. Really good distribution of the raisins, which I did not flour, but they're all through the cake. I know. There you go. And the raisins didn't need to be plumped up. They've taken the moisture out of the cake. They're nice, plump, soft, and the cake is still moist. I think if I had soaked the raisins ahead of time, the cake would be gummy.
Potentially.
Yeah.
Potentially, but yeah.
I think the cake would be
gummy.
What
if you can make it with pear sauce?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
I
with
like
pear sauce
a lot.
Yeah. I mean, pineapple.
Maybe. I don't know. Pineapple might be too liquidy.
I think a pureed pineapple would work really well. Definitely a pureed pineapple.
Well.
But pineapples.
What are you thinking?
Pineapples didn't grow in Pennsylvania in the 1930s.
No.
So there you go. What you got was applesauce. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon. Did you knead up chicken? Is that what you needed?
We need to do a shake and shop chicken.
See? It's cake.
You don't like cake.